Hi there, and thanks for joining us here on the web. Fire officials say that a fire pit is likely the cause of a house fire in Nashua. The family living in the home has their neighbors to thank for alerting them to the flames. Kriya Sakakini has the story from Nashua, and it comes with a warning from the city's assistant fire chief.
The owner of the home says he's used the fire pit on his back porch several times in the past and never had a problem. That's why he's surprised the fire pit could possibly be to blame.
I just had to get a glass of water and I spotted the flames shooting out the back.
Norm Jambart says he called 911 while his wife Pauline ran across the street to get their neighbors out of their burning home.
She definitely saved our lives, I think.
Jason Forbes says he had no idea his back porch was on fire and that flames were quickly spreading up the side of his house.
It was amazingly, the flames were above my roof.
Fire officials believe a portable fire pit the family was using on the porch is the likely cause, but Forbes says he thought it was out before he, his wife, and child went inside for the night.
We probably waited about an hour in front of the fire. It was out, no embers, no nothing, and then we went inside the house.
But Nashua's assistant fire chief says portable fire pits can be very dangerous.
Grills, fire pits shouldn't be on balconies and apartment buildings. When it comes to a private home, definitely hard to enforce. That's more of a common sense.
Forbes says his home on Peel Road is unlivable until renovations that could cost more than $250,000. Given the speed of the flames, he's just grateful his family is safe.
When I went back in just 5 minutes later to get my cat, I couldn't even enter the door. So it would have taken only five more minutes.
The family made it out of the home without any injuries, but one firefighter did have to be sent to the hospital for dehydration. In Nashua, Kriya Sakakini, WMUR News 9.
A man is facing an attempted murder charge after police say he stabbed his brother and nephew in Salem. Police say 49-year-old Jeffrey Sullivan of Lawrence, Massachusetts, showed up to 84 Bridge Street just before 11 last night to confront some family members. He's accused of puncturing a tire in the driveway, which then led to a fight. Police say during the fight, Sullivan stabbed his brother in the arm and his 21-year-old nephew in the chest and abdomen. Jeffrey Sullivan is facing a fugitive from justice charge in Massachusetts, where he was taken into custody. Autopsies will be done today on two people found dead in an apparent murder-suicide in Charlestown. Authorities discovered the bodies of two adults yesterday morning inside a home after a call to 911 was made. Investigators aren't releasing the victims' names or how they died, but say the case is domestic violence related. Dover police say a man wearing a surgical mask got away with drugs from a local pharmacy. The robbery happened at the Rite Aid in the Shaw's Supermarket Plaza. Police say last night around 6, the man demanded OxyContin from the clerk. No weapon was shown in the robbery. This is the second OxyContin-related robbery in the city in less than a month. Starting tonight at 5, the summer is almost over, which means a new school year for students nationwide. The new plan the federal government has come up with to help them succeed. And more changes to your credit card accounts. The final provisions going into effect this weekend to give you more protection. That does it for us. Have a great afternoon.